Step to the side. You'd better run and hide. Mine to the side. Everybody wants to stay alive. Step to the side. You'd better run and hide. Mine to the side. Everybody wants to stay alive.
You better stop. What is your major malfunction?
Welcome to the Chub Dog Sports Talk Radio Show.
Sound off like you've got a pair.
We're a spontaneous sports talk, rated R.
Don't make a fuck out of me.
Host Brandon Chabner.
Let's go, Brandon.
And producer Eric DeWell Red.
You're one smart fuck.
Bring you pregame picks with passion. With analysis from Abe Miranda.
First, I have to read you the Miranda rights.
Flicks.
Let's get ready to rumble.
Plus special guests, music, movie clips, comedy.
So fat, the blood type is red goo.
Always a little politics.
It's a bear in the woods.
Let's go, Brandon. Let's go, Brandon.
Join in the fun.
Hello.
And now, here's your host, Chab Dog.
Thank you.
All right, hello everybody, and welcome to another edition of Chab Dog Sports Talk. We're on now on Saturdays, 9 to 11 a.m. Pacific Time, and brought to you by Chabner Law, serving Southern California's transactional and business legal needs and estate planning. Also, you can check out the blog at chabdog.com, and there's a Facebook page as well. So this is the these picks. Our kicking and screaming show, and hopefully there's a lot of things we can really be confident about going into Sunday. I guess we'll have to see if we can delude ourselves that way. Want to welcome in Abe Miranda to the studio here. Always a big pleasure to have you here.
Thanks.
Yeah.
It's always nice to be here in Newport Beach, California, with clear skies and nice little weather going on here. We're always, of course, doing a lot better than the rest of the country. And everything's always looking much nicer here at Newport Beach.
Yeah, it's a little nippy out there. That's why we moved inside temporarily. We probably will be back out in a few weeks. But for now, we're going to keep it warm here. And Eric, thank you for Eric the Well-Read, my co-host, who it's not easy to arrange this show, particularly when you're switching locations like this, and you did a great job getting that done.
Hey, Chab Dog. Yeah, it's a cool 55 degrees currently right now as we kick off the show here at 9:30 a.m. And this morning, you know, it was in the high 40s. So we're going to continue. I really wanted to keep the show outside, but we're going to continue the show inside until the temperature gets back up over the 60s. Probably only going to take a few weeks here. But we're going to move to this location for now.
Okay. Yeah. Well, with global warming and everything, that should be no problem.
Yeah. I mean, what happened to this global warming? Where'd it go?
Everybody's complaining because it got a little cold last night. But yeah. Made for good sleeping. And there's Blix in North Carolina. You're back this week to, I guess, gloat about your 11 wins or something.
Yeah. Fabulous week last week. Blix, how'd you do it?
Yeah.
I just picked on a whim. I seriously just looked at the games. I didn't look at injury reports or anything like that. I just went with it. I mean, that fiasco at the airport last Saturday was it. I was so mad. I really didn't lose my anger until the next day.
So they wouldn't, you didn't have a paper ticket, so he wouldn't take you to the game.
Yeah,
is that it?
I don't know. For people that fly a lot like I do, you've got the apps on your phone, and sometimes when you check in, it'll say gate agent. But you're already checked in. You can get through security with that. You just got to go to your gate, and they'll print your ticket right there.
Correct.
That is what my app said. And the guy with the wheelchair was like, well, you don't have a paper ticket. I can't get you through security, and walked off.
Oh. So he didn't give you a choice?
No. No choice at all. So I go to the kiosk, and because of the fiasco with him, it was too late to check in, and by that time, I'd already missed the flight, and I was stuck there for another 4 hours.
Well, at least you didn't have to wait the next day.
That was a good thing. At least I got home on Saturday.
Which airport were you in?
I was at the Hartford Airport, Hartford, Connecticut.
Okay.
I think it's Bradley or something like that.
So if you're a traveler, how many airports have you had to sleep in over the years?
Honestly, two. Only two.
Oh, okay. Only two for me as well. Which two did you sleep in?
Phoenix and Vegas.
Vegas, I'd like. Phoenix, I wouldn't.
Yeah, Vegas is a pretty good airport.
Vegas, I'd be. I don't mind sleeping there.
Vegas, I'd be like, I'm getting out of the airport. Yeah. I'll see you guys in the morning.
I'll sleep somewhere else. I'm not gonna sleep in the damn
I was working in Vegas at the time, and I was supposed to have a red eye flight back home. The flight got canceled, so I was already tired of Vegas. It was time to come back home. It wasn't like I was busy.
I got you. I got you.
Well, at least that's better than Chicago, O'Hare, and Denver.
The buffet.
Think about think about your options. Maybe you need to hire Chabner Law. We can provide some small law advice for you.
Is that a short joke?
Yeah, in last week's show, in your absence, we discussed starting the small law firm.
Yeah,
big bills at the small law firm.
You could be our special
advisor.
Yeah,
I listened to the show on Thursday when I was on my way to Columbia.
You heard everything, eh?
I heard everything.
We probably slipped some barbs in there for you because you weren't there.
Oh, yes.
I don't remember, though.
There was some good stuff in there. It was a good show.
Anyway, what's going on with college football? Do you have anything for us in terms of special bowl game picks?
Well,
anything like that?
There's a couple interesting games this week. One game going on right now, Western Kentucky and Appalachian State. Both teams forgot to bring their defense. They're just going back and forth up and down the field. It's 31-24, and it's not even halftime.
WKU, what is their mascot?
I have no idea.
Don't they have a weird mascot? The Western Kentucky?
Yeah, it's a guy dressed in a costume looking really weird.
No, seriously, it's a cool name, and I can't. The Hilltoppers. The Hilltoppers. Yeah,
that creepy hillbilly.
I took a picture next to the Hilltopper because we visited Western Kentucky with my son.
Mm-hmm.
I like that place.
Over Alabama?
It's a different feel, but mm-hmm. it's got all sorts of interesting stuff on the campus, like about the Civil War.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of fighting in there. That's the border state, all border states.
True.
And it's kind of charm to it, that school. So anyway, do you have an opinion on the UCLA NC State Holiday Bowl game?
I do, because I've been starting to pay attention to NC State football a little bit more because they got off to a pretty decent start this year, and I was like, nobody's taken into account their schedule and what they've done, and that game looks like NC State could beat UCLA.
Is UCLA favored by like 4 or 5?
I don't know. I don't know what the favorability is in that game.
It's
got to
be pretty low, tight spread there.
NC State -1.
Oh, wow.
Wow.
See, UCLA had some bad losses, but they're playing better now, and this isn't in their territory, so I would think UCLA is going to win this game. Fight, fight, fight.
The Holiday Bowl, right?
The Holiday Bowl.
Yeah.
It's a good game.
Yes. The San Diego County Credit Union Holiday Bowl.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
No.
You don't want to talk about it because it's not one of the major bowls?
Well, I don't mind the Holiday when it's a good matchup. But
this is Blix's whole thing. He finds the games that people aren't necessarily most
focused on. Yeah, this is one of those
He unearths what's going to happen, so.
It's really strange because NC State is the designated home team, but the game's mm-hmm. being played in San Diego.
Yeah, which is naturally going to draw UCLA.
They're
going to
be wearing home jerseys mm-hmm. and getting booed out of the building because there's going to be a lot more UCLA fans there.
Yeah.
But
sure.
I still think NC State wins this game.
Okay.
I do. I don't think UCLA can keep up with them. It might be close in the first half, but NC State will take over in the fourth.
Okay. Abe, you want to weigh in on this at all? You don't have to.
Well, it's the Holiday Bowl. It's going to be in San Diego. That's pretty cool. I mean, that's a nice – the weather's going to be good.
It usually is a good game of the secondary bowl games. I like that game. I always like this game. So.
Yeah. Yeah, that'd be, I'm aligning it, but I really shouldn't. It's usually an entertaining game, whoever's playing. It's usually focused on some. The trouble is, it's offense.
It's the one that's played.
Does NC State have a good good passing attack, Blix?
They are pretty well balanced. I mean, they can throw the ball downfield, or they can run it down your throat.
Okay.
They can do anything, but they're also inconsistent. They've had some stretches.
Exactly.
I saw that. They were lucky to win that North Carolina game.
Entertaining holiday bowls are ones where there's like a passing attack, and it's 44-43, you know, finals.
This,
I love this.
This feels like
San Diego State's playing.
UCLA high-scoring game of victory, close victory.
Mm-hmm. They did have one of those games, a 44-something game this year, too, didn't they?
Well, they destroyed USC.
No. Yeah, they did that. Yeah, thanks. But, I mean, one where it was the other team was competitive, too.
Yeah, I'm sure. I'm sure.
You don't recall, but anyway.
Yeah. So that's an interesting game. What else do you want to? Anything else? Outside of the big ones that you want to talk about?
These are two interesting games coming up this week. Is on Tuesday, Texas San Antonio against San Diego State. I think that'll be one hell of a good game. And UCF in Florida. Everybody's overlooking UCF because they're playing a Power 5 school, and Florida's only favored by 6.5 in that game.
Yeah, I'm sure UCF would love to shock the world by winning that game.
Again,
yeah. They're up-and-comers, and they have been for a while.
That's a good program. Seems like a good pick to take.
It's evolving.
Is it the Bulls? What are they called? UCF.
UCF.
Is that
Golden
Knights? Well, the Golden
Knights. That's USF. I think it's the Golden Knights.
Right. Okay.
Yeah, it's very inoffensive.
And what bowl game is Pitt playing in? They're playing in the Orange Bowl?
Pitt in the Orange Bowl. Oh, good for them if they made the Orange Bowl.
They won the ACC.
Okay. That's Orange Bowl material.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So I wonder who they play, like Oklahoma maybe?
It's the Peach Bowl, and it's Pittsburgh, Peach Michigan Bowl. State.
Oh, okay.
They didn't get the better bowl than that.
Well, they'll beat Michigan State.
I don't know. That'll be an interesting game. Michigan State can always surprise you with their offense.
Oh, the reason why they didn't get the Orange Bowl is because the college football playoff is being played in the Orange Bowl. That's the Georgia-Michigan game.
Okay. Well, yeah, I like Pitt to win that game. They're a better team.
I do, too. I agree with you.
That's one
Michigan
team
State's
I know.
Had this habit of going they into big games and people going, Michigan State should be the one to win this game, and they're just falling flat on their face, and I think they'll do it again against Pitt.
Yeah, they're really not that great. They did beat Michigan, though.
Yeah, they beat Michigan, but after that, who have they played?
Exactly. They just played and lost to people in the big, you know, all the good teams. So, like Ohio State killed them, right?
That's the joke.
Purdue beat them. Wisconsin probably beat them. I don't know.
They only got two losses on their record, but it was.
Okay, so it's just,
I think they got both of those losses after they beat Michigan.
It was Ohio State and Purdue, I think. Yeah.
It's the
Purdue game.
Yeah, Purdue beat them by 11, and Ohio State beat them by 49.
Yeah, I mean, the Ohio State game was just, that was the end of my respect for them, even though Ohio State's a good team, but Michigan State folded like a house of cards.
Oh, yeah.
So, all right, well, we can end the college discussion now if you want. It's up to you.
Thank you.
I don't want to cut you short.
Oh, there you are with the short jokes again. But it's good.
No, I wasn't even thinking about that. I was just talking.
Yeah, we can talk about the other bowl games next week because everything's coming up. That's after Christmas. That's when the real good bowl games are supposed to be, and we'll talk about those next week. So if we want to continue on
that's
with something else, let's do it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Well, much better. Because this is that week where the NFL is supposed to take over the Saturday because there are no bowl games. There's no college going on. You know, they're all doing exams or they're getting ready for their bowl games right now. And here we had two games scheduled today, but one of them got moved.
Okay. So let's talk about the one that's, and you got to play the NFL music, right?
Well, okay. We can talk about that or we can talk about the fact that game got moved here. Today's game.
We could bitch and moan about COVID.
Yeah, we can bitch on about here before we start the chips. Yeah, the Browns and the Ravens. Yeah, because the Browns don't have anyone to start a quarterback right now. Both Baker Mayfield and Case Keenum,
yes,
are on COVID protocol, whatever that stuff is. So they don't have anyone. Who's the third stringer there?
We didn't have one. We just signed some guy, and I don't even know who the hell he is.
So it's some guy.
I was serious. No, they just signed a quarterback. And
Julio.
his name is replaced.
I've never heard of this guy whatsoever. You know, late in the year, like, you'll get this 30-something quarterback that used to be a backup, and they'll call him in and go, hey, play quarterback this week, and we're going to fire you after the week. No, I've never heard of this guy.
All I can say is it couldn't have happened to a nicer bunch of guys than the Cleveland Browns.
Well, all I can say is, and they still can't give... They still can't give Colin Kaepernick a job. Hello. This is what I'm talking about. I say it every week. There's another, you know, some bum-ass quarterbacks playing. It's like, this, you know, Colin Kaepernick would be better than that. You know, Colin Kaepernick's better than anything out there, but no, they can't hire him for whatever reason. He's a great talent. I mean, they can't.
They can still hire him.
Exactly. They should. Anyway. Oh, well, too bad about
somebody.
So sorry. Well, maybe, do we know who's going to start even on Monday? Will one of those quarterbacks be ready?
No, right now, like I said, we signed that one quarterback, but there's no guarantee. I mean, Stefanski tested positive too, so we don't even know if he's coaching the game.
Uh-huh.
It's just a mess. I mean, we might as well just go get the high school kids from the high school down the street from Cleveland Browns Stadium and go, here, y'all just play the Raiders and we'll take the loss.
Sure.
Don't worry about it.
Yeah.
It's tragic. It's all you need is maybe three more wins to win the division.
Okay,
well, maybe two.
Here's a hypothetical question for you, John. Let's roll the clock back 3 years. And if the same thing was happening but changed COVID for a flu outbreak, would we be postponing the game? Would they be preventing players from playing
if they had
the flu?
Completely different.
No, it's not.
It's completely different.
How is it completely different?
It'll be viewed completely differently.
Well, it is viewed completely different, but I'm posing to you why.
Because that's what we've been told, is that we have to believe that.
Okay, but...
This is more dangerous, I guess, so...
But now that we had time to look at this, that's what they've been insinuating, I guess, because it's not even... I don't hear it that overtly either. That's what they're insinuating. But now that I've looked at it, do you think... I don't believe that's true anymore, do you?
The numbers don't seem to bear out that this variant is as dangerous as the mothership, so...
As dangerous as any of them, actually. That none of this is really that. It's dangerous for certain groups, certain ages. Very dangerous. But for the rest of us, especially people
vaccinated,
it's really not
that
dangerous.
Nobody's bothering to make that distinction, though.
It's just like the flu.
So.
The flu is very dangerous. Yeah, we've had very bad flu years over the last few decades.
And do you know what the number of people that died from the flu was over the past, I think it was the past year? Was like 2,000 officially.
Well, it's lower than
it's usually 60,000.
Yeah, it's usually 60 to 180,000.
So it's like the question is... Why? How can you explain that? Why would that possibly happen? Is it just because of social distancing and all that stuff?
Or they counted deaths as COVID instead of flu.
Yeah.
I mean, it's the same thing. It's the flu. I mean, COVID is the flu.
Because the healthcare system gets rewarded for calling things COVID because they get money.
They get money. They got paid. I mean, it's, no one's reporting on that story either. That hey, good, free healthcare. we don't give out free medicine. We just did the last 2 years. Abe, you're shaking your head.
Well, they just... You know, I mean, you know, we live in a world today that's quite a lot different than it was 3 years ago, and that's the world we live in today. Today, when we do have outbreaks of COVID and any variant of COVID, well, they're going to postpone games. They're going to do things. They're going to lock down. You know, that happened to the state of California. We've implemented a statewide indoor mandate.
Oh yeah, we should actually be wearing masks, probably.
Where's your mask?
But it's Orange County, right?
But no, in Orange County, it's statewide. They're superseding county control, and
the
Governor Newsom said everyone has to
wear
a mask.
The question is, who's going to enforce this, and to what extent? So
yeah, well, but all you pussies up in LA County, you guys were all wearing your masks before, weren't you?
Oh, that's going to affect right now.
Wednesday, as a Wednesday.
Yes. So LA County, where I live, has been very strict from the get-go. And so now we've had a statewide indoor mask mandate. And so now...
You can't tell the difference, can you?
Now in Orange County, which they've had a little bit more liberal policy on it, they've all had to now go into a more... Welcome to LA County, boys.
Yeah, okay. And that's what I thought. But then I walked into a supermarket yesterday.
Yeah.
Nobody's wearing masks. Nobody that wasn't before. Like, we're Orange County.
Orange County is still rebelling.
We're ignoring it, and nobody's enforcing it. Well,
I like
so far.
LA is different.
I always like to say Orange County is the Florida of California. You know,
it's better than that. It's not get carried away.
I'm talking about the
don't
way
get
that they
carried
do,
away
they're,
with
they're
yourself,
the rebels.
Please.
They're the rebels in California. No. You know.
No, we're actually the most conservative people in California. On the contrary.
Well, that's what I mean. They're more of the conservative
yes.
side. So it's a whole different ball game when you walk into Orange County than the rest of California.
Yes.
So.
Yeah. People are a little more conservative, regardless yeah. of their walk in life or their race or their creed. They're just a little more conservative. We all come from, you know, all of us, white, Latino, black, Asian, a lot of Asians. But they tend all to Vietnamese, huge Vietnamese population here in Orange County. But they all tend to be a little more conservative. We like it yeah. that way.
Yeah.
And, like, less less off government control. We also don't like government telling us what to do. Yeah.
Conservative like that guy in the Watermelon Man clip.
Oh, that's a great clip, but I want to play these 5 minutes when we play the Watermelon
long,
Man.
We can't get lost in that right now.
Well, not yet. Not yet.
Maybe around the break.
Okay.
So, all right, so do we have a game to pick for...
We do, but I just want to give some praise one more time to Abe and Blix uh-huh. last week, who, you know, first time we had two people hit...
Double digits?
Double digits. 11 mm-hmm. wins.
Nice.
Congratulations, gentlemen. Do,
yeah,
can you do
they can go first this week since they're so smart.
The 11. The 11.
The 11.
The 11.
Okay.
Play 11 picks.
All right, let's get into it. First up, we have... Oh, and by the way, we all took the the Chiefs on Thursday night. So we all have a win. So we all come into this weekend tied. Tonight, gentlemen, we have a Saturday game. The Patriots are in New England. Are they in New England? No, they're in Indianapolis playing the Colts. 8:30 Eastern time, 5:30 here in Newport
Beach.
Ooh,
that'll be a hot game.
Colts are a two-point favorite.
Prime time.
And,
Esteban, you'll even, like, take time away from your dates to go watch this game because it's going to be a good game.
This is actually Esteban, who was our sound director. This is actually the kind of game you take a date to a bar and watch with her because the crowd will be all excited and pressing up, and then she'll like be forced to get closer to you.
Yeah, and she'll get she'll get excited.
She'll
watching,
get excited by the crowd
watching Tom Brady,
and you know you get a couple of drinks, and it always worked for me.
Carson Wentz,
yeah, Carson Wentz.
Does she like redheads?
So, Blix, you know, the Colts are third in the league in scoring. They've kind of snuck up on us here, and they've been in the last three, they've scored at least 30 points in seven of their past eight games. The Colts. I mean, who could imagine that? So, they're a two-point favorite against the Patriots tonight. Who do you like, Chapak?
You're making me go first.
Oh, sorry. All right, Blix, I'll make you. You're right. We'll go, the winners get to go first.
These experts.
Yeah, the wieners.
I want to hear what Blix has to say.
Yeah, I mean, the Colts' rushing game really picked it up in the last four or five games, and Taylor's looking like an MVP candidate. But one thing that Bill Belichick is good at is shutting down the opponent's best weapon. I don't see Jonathan Taylor running for 200 yards in this game. He might break 100. He'll probably score one or two touchdowns.
Mm-hmm.
But New England is on a roll. I mean, you win a game by throwing only three passes, and then you go into next week, and you win again. This is Bill Belichick at his best. He will shut down Indy's running game, put it on Carson Wentz's shoulders, and he will not be able to handle it. Give me the Patriots.
Okay. It's,
he's going down for the Pats, huh?
Going down for the Pats.
Well,
Is T.Y. Hilton, do you have any intel on T.Y. Hilton this week?
T.Y. Hilton,
is he permanently gone?
Not here so far. I don't see anything. You see anything, Blix?
Blix, T.Y. Hilton?
I didn't see anything on T.Y. Hilton.
Okay.
I don't see anything there. But I can tell you that the New England Patriots, Damian Harris, their running back is out. Mm-hmm. They won't be in this game.
Mm-hmm.
That's a little bit of a factor for me. Looking at just kind of the... offense here, it looks like the Colts are actually going to bust in a little bit more offense than defense for the Pats. Of course, Pats defense is good.
But I actually like the fact that the spread isn't too large here for the spread's not that bad. Not that bad for it's almost a money line pick. What? How many points?
Yeah, 2 points. Who's going to win? That's what they want to know.
Yeah.
Colts.
Look at the Colts. Like Colts at home.
I gotta try to catch up to Blick somehow, you know?
Mm-hmm. Well, you tried it last week and it didn't work.
Well,
you tried it last week and you tied me.
Yeah, I mean, well, you know, that was actually pretty good, though. I'm not, you know, not too bad.
This could go either way, obviously. So, I just don't trust Carson Wentz. I think he's going to make a critical mistake. The Patriots are too disciplined on defense, and they've been they're really good at taking somebody's best tool and rendering it useless or not very impactful, and they can stop the run. So I would say Patriots here.
Yeah, I'm leaning into your line of thinking here that they're just Indianapolis got the momentum. They're exciting. They're excited. They're looking to do new things. Frank Reich.
Yeah, but it feels like the Tampa Bay game. You know, where they just kind of laid an egg.
Yeah, it's just Belichick. You're playing the Patriots. Belichick knows how to coach. He can outcoach Frank Reich. So sorry.
All right. See, we isolated you.
Yeah, but if we lose, he gets to move up.
That's okay.
To reap,
you know
rewards.
What? I look at the numbers. You guys just have this little gut feeling.
This wasn't,
you know what
a
I'm
kicking
saying?
And screaming pick either.
It's all right.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, one more time.
What's next?
Sunday morning.
Next.
1 p.m. Eastern, 10 a.m. here on the West Coast. The Cowboys are going to line up against the Giants in New York. Giants are an 11-point home dog. And the Giants, geez, they had Mike Glennon will start at quarterback. Mike Glennon, everybody. So
they must be really sick about that.
Blix, you're an 11-point winner. Who do you like?
Oh, this is an easy game to pick. I mean, the Giants are just in shambles, and Dallas is starting to look like a playoff team again. And even though that spread
beating
is
Washington
11
last
points,
week, yes.
Even though that spread's 11 points, I think they could probably double it against the Giants. I'm taking the Cowboys.
Yeah.
Was that did the Giants play last week? Have they had 2 weeks off?
They played last week.
And who'd they must
they
have lost?
Against Washington? And they...
No, they played the Chargers.
The Chargers. Yes.
And got beat by 16.
And they lost, the
Chargers.
They lost
about
by
the,
like
the
two touchdowns, yeah. Three touchdowns.
37-21. Yeah. Was the final score.
It's tough because Dallas could well just squeak a win or win by, say, 8 or 9, and who cares?
11.
11's a lot of points.
That's a lot of points.
11's a lot.
Last time I checked, it was
11.
But Dallas, the Giants, just their offense isn't. I think I'm going to go with Dallas.
Dude, Mike Glennon. Mike
the 11.
There's nothing there for the Giants.
Glennon.
I don't know how they scored 21 points last week.
Yeah, but there's 11 there.
The 11.
Okay.
You can do it? 11.
Yeah, go for it. The 11. I'm going to do it.
Abe.
Wow. You know, it's tough because offensively, defensively, you know, it does favor the Cowboys. 11 points is kind of stiff, but against the Giants... Giants suck, so let's put me down for the Cowboys this week.
Wow. Dallas. Well, here's a betting nugget here for you. The Giants' home games are 5-0-1 to the under. Oh, on the under. Yeah, that's not. I thought it was for the. No, they weren't against the spread. All right.
Nobody's
screw
scoring
it.
Any points there, huh?
I'm taking Dallas, too. Yeah, they're going to shut down Glennon, and they're going to prove why they're a decent team. They're worthy of winning the NFC East. Next up, we have the Texans at the Jaguars. Oh, okay, and Abe, you remember last week on this very show, I posed the question to you, should the Jaguars, Shad Khan, the owner, fire Urban Meyer now or wait to the end of the season? Do you remember?
So we did it. It's all our fault.
It's all our fault. We started here.
I'm sorry. But I told him, fire his ass. Just fire his ass. Fire!
He sounded as bad as the coach on the kicking and screaming clip.
Actually, I was kind of surprised when they actually fired his That'd ass this week. Point. I was like, wow, I said fire his ass, and they fired his ass. I was like, wow, I'm so happy. I've never been – I've called a lot of things right this week. You know, first my 11 picks, we fired Urban Meyer's ass, and then we've got the whole Formula One thing we'll talk about later today. But it's just like, wow, I'm on a hot streak this week, guys.
Doing right. That's right.
Yeah, Urban Meyer should have seen this clip.
Yeah, let's go on camera four, please.
He really could have been
I don't think that's a very good attitude. You can't talk about hurting other players. If you don't think.
Yeah. Urban Meyer should have watched this movie.
But I don't think you should be butting in when I'm talking to my team. Flicks. You're my assistant, okay? You're supposed to back me up and go get me juice boxes when I tell you. Now go get me a juice box. You know who you're talking to. I'm talking to the juice box guy. You're crazy. Well, I'm not crazy. I'm just thirsty. Why don't you go to hell? No, you go to hell. While you're there, why don't you grab me a juice box? I'm no juice box boy, I'll tell you that. Yes, you are. No, I'm not. Yes, you are. No, I'm not. Yes, you are. No, I'm not. You're like your old man. I'm not like my old man. If it weren't for these kids, I would whip your butt. I can take a punch. I'm out of here. Bye-bye. I'll see you, Mr. Big Time Coach. Bye-bye. I'm not like my old man. I'm a kind and gentle, compassionate human being with a heart as big as a lion. We'll see you later, Juice Box! Everyone wave goodbye to Juice Box! Literally wave! Do it! Here's two! Everyone wave! Okay. Guys. I only want winners out on the field. Who's a winner? I said, who's a winner? Everyone's hand should be up. Okay.
Urban Meyer.
Who are we?
Tigers!
What?
Tigers!
All right, let's break someone's clavicle on three. One, two, three. Break someone's clavicle. Hit the field. Let's go.
That's a trick, you know that?
Move it, move it. Huh? Pick up that piece of trash, Tom. Tuck in your shirt. What are you doing? Have a sense of pride, huh? In fact, why don't you take a lap? Go run a lap.
It's just like Urban Meyer, man.
Pick it up. Faster! Here we go! Go! Hey, off the field. Off the field, Tarzan. I'm off. Defense! Come on! You guys know anything about defense?
Dad.
Yeah. Not now, Sam.
Can you put me in?
Later, because later. Go grab some bitch. Come on, come on! There we go, John Piero. Look good.
Think you can mark him?
Yeah, I can take him.
JJ, Zach, everybody see what we got to do with these guys? Four on one, three on another, right? We have to, we really have to smother.
What he is, yeah. Okay. Yeah. I'll cut this. Stop. There we go. All right, gentlemen.
All right, we're back. And after that lighthearted jab at Urban Meyer, who is no longer perusing the sidelines of Jayville.
Okay, we're
Esteban. Nice, Esteban. Nice having you here. It was short and sweet.
Sound engineer and director. Thank you so much. Thank you, Sam. We'll
take care of yourself tonight. Don't do anything crazy. Okay, do it for yes. We Esteban. Live vicariously through Esteban.
Silver Light Studios.
Yeah, Silver Lake Studios is the name of his company?
His company, yeah.
Okay.
Silver Light. Silver Capture. Okay, well, old school.
Silver something.
Silver Capture Studios, yes. Just sound, audio, cameras, video.
We'll give him the Silver Slugger Award, whatever that is.
It's a long way of coming back to the Texans and the Jaguars.
I'm going with the Jaguars. They're going to rally. It's time to rally around the Jags now that they have a new coach. I don't know who it's going to be, but I'm sure they'll find somebody. Maybe they can put a Craigslist ad out or something.
Craigslist ad. It sounds more like what Cleveland needs to do for their quarterbacks. Yes. We're not picking that game
yet. Absolutely.
Okay,
that's a good idea.
Every time I've gone with the Texans, I've gotten it wrong, so I got to stay away from them.
Okay, so you're betting the Jaguars. Blix, what do you think?
I'm going to go with Chav Dog on this one. The Texans have just been horrible and even horrible at being horrible. So I think this is the week that Trevor Lawrence can actually be a leader instead of having to deal with a guy like Urban Meyer on the sidelines. He'll have somebody that will listen to him, and he'll be able to make the right calls at the line of scrimmage. Low-scoring game, must-miss television, but the Jaguars win this one.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, this is good. These are the two lowest-scoring offenses in the league here. Davis Mills is going to be starting quarterback for
They
for
keep
Houston.
Throwing him out there.
Yeah. Yeah, and of course we've got Trevor Lawrence, who, thank goodness, Urban Meyer was fired, so he won't get miscoached by that bozo of a coach again. You know, gets to salvage his career finally.
He was a better analyst, I think.
Houston's also 0-7 outright again, and 2-5 against the spread when Mills is starting at quarterback, so they've got a horrible record against the spread when he's starting, which he's done for 7 games now.
Mm-hmm.
I like the angle. They fired Meyer. Teams with fired coach that play the following week after fired coaches usually win.
The Raiders did.
Yeah, the Raiders did. So
yeah,
that's precedence there. So, Jags. Abe, are you going to jump on the Jaguars?
You know, that sounds like a good bandwagon to jump on, especially since they both suck so bad.
It's also good to be on your own island.
They suck so bad. They both
reap the big reward.
For people that are actually going to watch this game, it'll be like watching the Seattle Kraken play hockey.
Well, that's probably right. That's true. I'm not going to argue there. We got some issues, Kraken. We're like a little squid. We're not a big squid. We're a little squid. All I can tell you is that this is horrible. It's a horrible game. And if you're going to pick one, I like the Jags, and that, you know, Trevor Lawrence got a little bit more freedom out there. You don't have Urban Meyer no more because apparently somebody listened to this show last week, and we're kind of like, hey, let's just see what's going on. It's a home game for the Jags, so if you're a Jacksonville Jaguar fan and you're in Jacksonville, there's probably the best people that are going to enjoy this game because I don't think anybody else is. But you know, here we go. That's what we got.
Okay, Abe, that was
Jags.
Your thought? Yeah, my thoughts exactly. That if you're a Jaguars fan and you're into player development and you're actually following Trevor Lawrence, who is a very promising quarterback, a great talent there, and you care for the guy because it's hard, you know, that's your team and it's hard not to care.
It's your rookie QB right there,
quarterback. Then these people are going to find this game very interesting, and I love the Jags. So, all right, and I'm actually looking. That's the live signal there for the YouTube, and we are going 360 there. Even YouTube's showing it, but a moment ago they were showing it normal. So. Anyway, what was that song? C'est la vie? It is what it is? Que sera, sera.
Anyway, Gladys.
Okay, so where are we now?
I'm jumping to the board here and hitting this.
There we go. Here on VR mode.
The Titans.
Titans.
Are at the Steelers. Oh, Chabot.
Oh, yeah. This is a great game.
Yeah, this is a great game. Sunday, 1 p.m.
This should just be really physical.
I hope it's on TV so you can watch it. Titans,
I think the stakes are high for one team, and the other team is just a physical, very imposing.
The line's been flipping on this, and by the way, our lines are courtesy of
the lines
games,
are going
Sportsbook.
Crazy.
And when we set this line, it has Tennessee favored at -1, but the Steelers have also been favored at minus one as well. But we're using the Tennessee favorite at minus one on our spread.
Okay. Well, lately you bet against the Steelers at home when they're underdogs at your own. I mean, it's a dangerous proposition.
Yes.
I know they've lost to some less than great teams at home this year, but I think right now they will bring their A game. The Titans don't have one of their big weapons. They've got Ryan Tannehill, who's a wild card. Mm-hmm. And I don't like the Titans past. The secondary is not good, and that should help Pittsburgh. So I'm going to go with the Steelers. A big surprise.
Yeah, you would have found a way to talk yourself into taking the Steelers anyway, wouldn't you?
On the road, I don't think so. But they're at home.
They're at home. And they're an underdog.
And they have to win the game. It's not the level of need is not the same.
Yes.
I don't think.
Yeah, the 6-6-1 Steelers against the 9-4 Titans, who don't have to win. Steelers have to win to keep any hope of the season alive. The Titans don't necessarily have to win.
And if the Colts lose tonight ahead of the game, then that takes even more pressure off of the Titans.
Correct. Yeah, the Titans don't. If they win tonight, it doesn't solve anything in terms of their playoff positioning at all. Obviously, it wouldn't hurt them, but it's not going to help them that much. Here's an interesting tidbit, Chad. The Steelers are currently last in the AFC North, and they've not finished last in their division since 1988, the longest streak without a last-place finish.
That was the Cleveland glory years.
The 1988. So who's the quarterback in 88? The name
was that. Was it Bobby Brister?
I was about to say the same thing. Was it Brister?
I think it was Bobby Brister.
Oh, my goodness.
Bobby Brister years.
But he went to. He may have gone to a playoff game.
Yeah, he did a playoff game once. One.
I liked him. He wasn't the greatest.
No, but just the name, Bobby Brister.
I liked the way he jumped around back there. And
yeah.
I don't know. He had personality.
He gave it his all. Blix, who do you like?
Interesting matchup because the Steelers' offense is, well, the Steelers' offense. Let's be honest, there's not much there. But the Titans do have the depleted secondary, and guys like Chase Claypool will have a chance to get open, even if he's double covered because of backups being in the game. But I still don't see a way that the Steelers win this game. I don't think the defense can keep the Titans under 20 points, and I don't think the Steelers can score 20 points.
But you probably feel the same way about the Baltimore-Pittsburgh game when they were playing, right?
Pretty much.
You probably didn't think the Steelers could win that game either.
Nope. And somehow, some way.
So there's a chance.
He took the Vikings last week against the Steelers.
Too. I like the dissension, and I might be on the island here, but go ahead, Eric. Tell me what you want to do.
Okay, well.
I'll let you go next.
So, Blix, yeah, you're taking the Titans. No, yes. I want the other 11-game winner to go next. Abe?
I like Mr. Chabdog here because he liked to pick his team because Pittsburgh Steelers. But even though they're going to lose the game against the Tennessee Titans, that's what I like about Mr. Chabdog. He'd be like, yeah, let's go with the Steelers. And we'd be like, no.
I go down with my master.
You know what? Let's
like a good, loyal dog.
Yeah. Pick the Titans. Pick the Titans.
Yeah. Abe's going with the sense of reason here.
Where's Lee Corso to go? Not so fast, my friend, when Chabdog picks the Steelers.
Yeah. Lee Corso, that'd be a good soundbite. Okay. Off the
so you want to pile on or what?
Yeah, you're right.
I've had a lot of time to think about this.
I know. I've really been...
And you have gone far picking the Steelers as a home underdog when in this kind of situation. I know you have.
Okay. Here's the stat. Since 2018, Pittsburgh is 17-6-1 against the spread as an underdog.
Yeah!
And 5-0-1 against the spread as a home underdog.
Yeah!
That is a strong trend.
That's not strong.
They've
won
four straight games outright as a home underdog, including two already this season. Put me down for Steeltown.
No question.
Look at that. Look at that. Yeah. He went with the stats.
So this is a swing game.
Trend
it's definitely
is
a
your
swing
game.
Yeah, you're right! It's okay. Stats can be broken. Stats can be broken, Blix.
Well, you know that 57% of all statistics are wrong.
Next up, we have the Cardinals, 10-3.
Thanks for nothing.
At the Lions, 1-11-1.
Talking about
in Detroit, but it's indoors now, so they're not going to get frozen. 1 o'clock tomorrow Eastern time, 10 a.m. Newport Beach time.
How much is it?
12 and a half points. The Cardinals are 12 and a half point favorites.
It's a nice reward for a Cardinals team that looked less than impressive last week.
You know, Arizona is one of two teams without a road loss this season. Can you name the other team? A road loss, yeah. And I didn't know Arizona was one either. Like I
don't know. It
doesn't have a road loss.
It doesn't have a road
loss. I just picked the Packers.
Nope.
Ah.
There's one other team.
There's one other team that does not have a road loss this season. Blix, any guesses?
I have no clue.
New England.
Ding, 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 ding.
Oh.
What's that?
The thrill of victory.
My Phil.
That's a lot.
Yeah.
Except Belichick.
I know my Patriots.
Jeez.
Yep.
That's a lot.
Okay. So I'm going to go with the Cardinals because I made a mistake last week. I'm not going to do it again. At least not 2 weeks in a row.
Yeah, but we made a mistake. We took the Cardinals and they lost to the Rams.
That's true too. But
yeah, so
the Lions
not get rewarded.
The Lions.
Well, sometimes they play close. You know that.
And the thing was that Kyler Murray looked really. He didn't look that great last week.
Detroit is 8-5 against the spread this season, and is 7-2 against the spread when getting at least 4 points. And this is last time I checked, it was 12.5. 7-2.
Detroit Lions are 1-5 at home.
Well, they're 1-11-1 overall.
Oof. They're 7-0 away. Yeah, so they're.
Should they fire their coach?
Yeah, fire their coach
they
too.
Just hired him too. He's a first year coach.
Fire them all.
This is a tester. This is a difficult game. Any game with the Lions, it's very difficult because there's an inherent. Like guilt for picking the Lions. It's
well, there's inherent guilt.
I have a bad feeling. Just a bad feeling.
Because we all feel so sorry for the Lions.
I definitely
Lions
wouldn't
fans.
Be putting money on the Lions.
Because we want, I'd love on to see Lions. Why can't Lions just go 9-7 every year and just be average and get lose in the first round? That would be so much better for everybody.
Quit stalling. I did. You guys still have to decide.
Mine's easy. Mine's easy.
Shut up. Get off.
Right. Mine's easy.
Go ahead, Abe.
I'm going with Cardinals. That's it. Period. Done.
Blix, is this one obvious?
This one is screaming? Very obvious. This is screaming Cardinals, especially after that piss-poor performance last week, and they get the Lions this week. It's time to show back up.
Yeah.
Yes, they're mad. They're mad. I'm even more mad I picked the Rams.
I'm taking the Cardinals, too. Yeah, we're all going to take the Cardinals here. So I'm tempted to, yeah, but I whenever I take the Lions, I get killed. Forget it. I'm not. I don't feel like
guilt involved with the Lions.
Yeah, definitely should
sacrifice. You know, even if they win, it's
and the agony of defeat.
We all lose.
It's okay.
On to better games with better karma. The Panthers are at the Bills. 1 o'clock Eastern, 10 a.m. here at the dock in Newport Beach.
That sounds like a slaughter to me.
Bills are 12-point favorites.
That's a Bills blowout. That's a Bills bargain basement blowout.
12 points, dude.
That's a lot.
Josh Allen is dealing with a foot injury, however.
Oh, so major injury?
Foot, yeah.
Is he listed as questionable?
Yeah, he's trending towards playing, which means he's questionable.
I think he's going to get over that. He's going to get over that.
But Newton and this other guy named P.J. Walker, who are going to be sharing the quarterback duties here, they've been doing a lot of baking lately. Yeah, they like baking desserts.
They've been having bake sales?
Yeah, turnovers.
Are you serious?
Serious. Newton sold four turnovers in the past two games, and Walker has thrown in at least one interception
enough
each of his past three.
Playing with my mind.
Yeah,
I thought that was some kind of public relations thing, maybe, that they were raising money for the blind,
blind the
sisters of Mary Catherine.
The more money they
I mean, Cam Newton's he needs to do something to justify his
existence. He contributed to that fund that they pay to the victims. Turnovers.
Let's just say Bills and move on. Does anybody have anything else to say?
It's so unseemly. 12 points, dude. I can't even.
I don't even care. Down. I just don't care.
Oh, why do I feel dirty?
I'm drunk with hate for the Panthers, and I got them right last week, so I'm going to go with it. Bet against them last week. I'm betting against them this week.
Blix, you're from North Carolina. Do you got something dirty you can say about the Panthers?
There's a lot to say about the Panthers. It's horrible. but I'm not actually going to dive into that. But right now, I'm a matchup predictor.
Blix at 5-8. Does Carolina people think that the Panthers still have a shot at the playoffs?
Oh, absolutely not. They know the season's over.
Yeah, they
all
even
the
if
Panther
they
fans
did,
that I know, they know the season's over. Matchup predictor gives Carolina a 19.4% chance of winning this game.
Yeah,
that's really
which I still think that's pretty high because it came out after the loss last week. The Panthers are 0-11 in Cam Newton's last 11 starts for the Panthers. So if he starts this game, you can almost guarantee the Panthers are going to lose, and Buffalo is still trying to stake claim to their division. They make a statement with this game tomorrow. It's going to be a blowout. Give me the Bills.
Yeah. Bills are 7-6. They can't afford to lose this game. But it's 12 points. They also don't need to win by 12. Abe?
I just whatever Blick just said, that's good enough for me. Blix. Thanks, Blix.
I said Buffalo from the very start, so.
Yeah, I'm a man on a Buffalo, too.
Mm-hmm.
Give me them Bills. Next up, we have the Jets at the Dolphins, the replay. Abe Miranda, you were at this game, weren't you? Version 1 with Tank?
Yes, yeah. I was with them.
Yeah, so here's, you know, they play twice a year. This time they're in Miami. Ooh. So it's the rematch. Dolphins are 9.5-point favorites.
Oh, that seems high for them.
Well, yeah, but they covered last time. Yeah, that was in New York.
That's true. That is true.
The 3-10 Dolphins against the Jets against the 6-7
covered the
Dolphins.
Spread in New York. They were favored probably to win by less than they won by.
I think they were favored.
They won by seven, I think.
No, they won by 10.
Oh, 10?
Yeah.
I remember then.
I think they were 9.5 point and they won by 10.
It was kind of a close game. It was, I don't know. But Miami's.
Well, Abe was there.
Kind of puts you to sleep. But you were not impressed.
You
got a good
by
defense.
Either team's performance.
I was definitely not impressed by their performance. And I will say that.
But look what happened last week. Miami beat somebody.
They beat the Giants.
Miami's won 5 in a row.
They beat somebody.
And they're on a bye week, too. So I think that might also help out a little bit. But so are the Jets. The Jets.
I like Miami. I'd say Miami.
Yeah, they're both coming off.
I'd say
Patriots are coming off a bye week.
It's out of reach in South Beach for the Jets.
Zach Wilson's throwing a lot of good interceptions. That's going to help.
Miami thinks they can make the playoffs now. So
yeah,
let them see that.
Yeah, they do have a little delusion going on there.
That's the difference between last game and this game. Was last time I watched them, Zach Wilson wasn't the QB. Where Sunday's game is going to be Zach Wilson. Tomorrow. So there's a little bit.
That's why I checked tomorrow, Sunday.
Tomorrow, yeah. So tomorrow, Zach Wilson.
But he did play last week, I think.
Yeah, he did, and they.
And he did badly.
Zach Wilson.
Yeah.
Oh my God, he pooped in the bed.
He sucks.
They let him go to bed without a diaper, and
so
he pooped the bed.
That might be the factor for me in choosing the Dolphins, simply because I think Zach Wilson might be an actual worse quarterback
another consensus, I think, here.
So let's just go with, and it's a home game. I think that's a difference, too. It's a Dolphins home game. I got a lot of people rooting for him down there. Warm. You're not going to have a swarm of Jets fans overcrowding the entire stadium there.
It's kind of looking like this is one of those weeks where we're all going down together or all rising together.
That's fine.
I take it you like Miami?
Yeah.
Alex, are you going to be swimming with the Dolphins?
Yeah, I'm going to go with the Dolphins on this one, too. The matchup predictor only gives the Jets an 18.6% chance of winning this game. And, you know, the Dolphins beating them by a touchdown and a field goal does not seem far-fetched to me.
Mm-hmm.
Zach Wilson likes to throw the football to the other team, so let him do it.
Yeah, Dolphins are good at catching opposing quarterbacks' as passes, so I like it. Here's a little tidbit. Only 3 teams in NFL history have gotten back to 500 after being 6-plus games below 500 at any point.
Mm-hmm.
That's the 1974 Jets, the 1984 Packers, and the 2009 Titans.
Mm-hmm.
So it's pretty relevant. But
thank you for dredging that statistic up.
Because the Dolphins have to win tonight to be 7-7.
Yeah.
Miami is 6-1 against the spread as a home favorite under Coach Brian Flores. Yeah, I like
it. It's a perfect opportunity for them to do that.
Give me the fish.
Okay.
I'm going to keep people happy.
So is that a good chance to go to the break, I think? We're done with the morning games. Let's.
I can't read the clock.
Yeah, we're way past it.
10:26.
No, but the clock, according to... We're 54 minutes in so far.
I don't know. I gotta go.
Just hit 55.
I need a special break for myself pretty soon here. So
all right. Well, we're at 55 minutes, so we can run a clip.
Yeah, like we could run. You could run the killing clip. It's an interesting clip from a movie about a horse race.
Since we have more time, why don't we run the watermelon then?
Yes, you could do that too. Okay.
And then when we finish that, guess what? We're going to be in the break.
Okay. Yeah, this is an interesting movie. You ever seen this movie, Blix?
I don't think I have.
The Watermelon Man. Oh, look.
But you have? I don't want to let y'all know we got a special cat.
Oh, he's got a kitty cat.
What's the kitty cat?
That's the cat I was telling y'all about 2 weeks ago. That's fat as hell.
It's the tabby.
He's as big as my leg.
Yes.
He's a big boy.
That is Mr. Kozo.
Mr. Coco.
Is he a real tough guy?
Mr. Coco.
What kind of cat is he? Is he aggressive?
No, he keeps to himself. He was an abused kitten. So he's standoffish until he really gets to know you. And he's more of a pet me now, keep petting me, give me my treats, now I'm going to go lay down on your suitcase type of cat.
Okay.
Oh, that's simple. That's pretty good. That sounds like my dog a lot. Yeah.
Maybe after a few nights, he'll be sleeping on your pillow.
But my dog likes to be touched by a person all the time. I mean, he'd be on your lap if he could.
Oh, yeah.
He doesn't go somewhere else.
Yeah.
Unless you kick him off. Well, that's nice. All right. Well, why don't you play that clip, run that clip, and we'll be back on the other side of this stuff, and we're going to take our break.
Yeah, so. I'll start it like a minute.
This was a great movie, though. This was about a...
Still 7 minutes.
Archie Bunker type white guy.
Dude,
who...
this guy don't look like any Archie Bunker.
He works out and stuff.
Very tan.
But he woke up one morning and he was black.
Okay.
Dark.
Back after the break. Check this out.
Very dark. Yes. Very. You stupid! No, it's not a joke. I am not Sid Percival pulling your leg. 42 Tangerine Lane, and I'm a dissatisfied customer. Hello? 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 Can you beat that? They want to send me a new sun lamp.
That's very sporting of them.
What the hell am I going to do with a new sun lamp?
Well, maybe you could make them.
You're just having a dandy time, boy.
Oh, relax, Jack.
Out there? You wouldn't hug me unless you really thought I was white, right?
Oh, poor baby. Don't worry. You'll be white again.
Hey, wait a minute.
What is it?
There are things that we can do. I mean, what do they do when they want to look white? They must use salves and creams.
Hair straighteners.
I don't want my hair straightened. I want my skin straightened. What the hell else are we talking about?
Where are you going?
To one of their drugstores. Call me a cab.
Your cab's here. What are you doing?
The door is not open on the cab. Go on out there and open the door on the cab. The colored section.
Nice neighborhood. What do you do there? Mow the lawn? What do they pay you?
I get to sleep with the lady of the house. Would you put your hands down? All I want is a pair of sunglasses. Now look, I got a skin problem. What's this and this? Give me a paper bag. Now, get me a box. A box. Big box. There you go.
All right, let's see now. Uh-huh. Right, yeah. Okay, give me some of these. Yeah, Afro Sheen. Uh-huh. All right, let's see now. Ah, we'll try some of this white folk stuff here. Let's see. Yeah, that's good. Beautiful bleach. That cabinet is great. Miracle wash. This is tear straight. That'll help. More processing stuff there. All right. You remember, if anybody asked you if you ever saw me in here, you never laid eyes on me. Okay. Mum's the word. Any change?
No. But I don't imagine it would be immediate. I mean, I don't think any intelligent Negro expects it to be immediate. Don't be so militant.
It's different. I'm not militant. I'm white. I expect it to be immediate.
We've rubbed in four different brands. Don't you think we ought to stop?
Well, come on. Put on some more hair straightener. Come on, here.
Jeff, I don't want you to get all excited, but I do think you're a little lighter. It's hard to tell through the cream, but...
I think you're right. around the neck here, right?
Especially around
the neck. And around the chin?
Yes, the chin, too.
And around the nose, huh?
Yes.
You're lying to me out there. Don't lie to me out there. Just don't lie to me. Oh, this is crazy. I don't want to be this color. What are you doing up there?
Calm down.
Oh, I'll yell all I want. He can't hear me. He's the white man's god.
Jeff, you are not a Negro.
Oh, my goodness. I'm getting dark. I just said, come on, get all this crap off me. Come on, quick. Oh, my goodness, I need more. Oh. Come on, I'm getting darker. I can just see
Jeff,
it.
Oh, calm down.
I can't take a shower, because if I take a shower, my body will shrink and the skin I have will fit.
Will you calm down? The children will be coming home from school soon, and I don't want you getting them upset.
Upset? Wait until they find out they have a colored daddy. Huh? Wait till I get down on my knee and I say, Mammy.
Talk yourself into it,
Jeff. Oh, my God. These creams don't work. No wonder Negroes riot.
Hi. Hi. I'm your father.
Sure. Hi, Dad.
Hi, Dad.
Don't you have anything you want to say to me?
Your face is dirty.
That's a nice thing to say to your father.
Sure is a heck of a tan you got, Dad. You look like a colored man.
That's very good. Thank you, Burton. We could use you at the UN.
Come on, kids. I'll get you dinner ready.
What are we having?
Black eyed peas, hominy grits, cornbread, hon hocks.
What's with him? Didn't get to raise his bus this morning. He's a little upset.
Why are you doing that, Daddy?
Doing what, sweetheart?
Racing buses.
Come on, Janice. You don't want your ham hocks to get cold. In here or in the dining room? What is it?
I gotta see. Maybe it's the lighting in here. Maybe in the daylight I'll look less colored.
What are you going to do?
I'm gonna go for a walk.
Where to?
In the backyard.
How brave of you.
Well, you're certainly getting whiter whites these days, aren't you, Mr. Johnson?
Oh, yes. I'm using a new detergent.
Well, I wish you'd tell my wife the brand, because we have a few things around our house that really need whitening.
Jeff, are you all right?
Yeah.
You're hardly breathing.
I don't want to ruin it.
You look like a birthday cake. Well, it's getting very late. Can't you at least lie down in bed?
No, I'm afraid I'll roll over and destroy the mold.
No, all right.
Althea?
Yes?
My last word. Pray for me.
Jeff?
Are you breathing?
Over now.
What we can do is now that we can that we're done, we can go back on, but not in VR mode. We could try that. We could shut down the stream and then come back up in non VR mode because they've already shut us down.
Well, hold on.
The legendary John Madden with his perspective on the retirement of Brett Favre. Mr. Madden, how do we handle this today?
What did you say?
Brett Favre is retired.
Retiring, sir.
What? But nobody had told me that.
Well, we're breaking the news to you then, I guess. Brett Favre is retiring from the NFL.
Wait. You mean, did he break down and cry, or did he, how did he do it? Hold on a second. Is Ashton Kutcher in the room?
No.
Come on, Ashton. Come out of here. Hold on. I'm checking his trash can. Look, he's not. This is real, guys. Brett Favre, we got to find. Say it ain't so, Shoeless Joe. This is worse than the Black Sox scandal. How's this going to be? I'm beside myself, and that's pretty hard to be in a room beside yourself with me.
So, what would be your fondest memories of Brett Favre?
Oh, just everything. I mean, everything he's ever done. Just watching him step on the field, you know, watching him play that night game. I think it was a Sunday night or a Monday night. I don't remember it anymore. After his, his dad passed away. He was farmless. I mean, that's the thing about Brett Favre is you think of all the things that you've always wanted to do and the things that you could do and the things that you can't do, and that's Brett Favre. He does it all. You can't put into words everything that Brett Favre has meant to the NFL and pretty much meant to, world peace. Brett Favre is there's a lot of bad things in the world. And I learned this watching the Dungeons and Dragons cartoons years ago. The universe needs balance. And that's what the Dungeon Master said. And he said, the universe needs balance. So if you drink some water and you get it out of nowhere, it doesn't come from nowhere. There's a farmer missing a little bit of water somewhere else. So the water balances. And Brett Favre balances. And right now the water's coming from my eyes because I'm tearing up here, guys. You just think, who else? There is no other Brett Favre. I mean, it's a two-syllable amazement. Brett Favre. I mean, you try it. Kurt Warner. It sounds okay, but it sounds, it doesn't, Brett Favre. Hear that? Kurt Warner. Here's the closest I could get. Tony Romo. That's pretty good. Roethlisberger. It just doesn't have that Favre. And the fact that the R and the V don't even match up with the Irv, it makes you think, hey, this was meant to be. I mean, I remember going back to the early days where you had to describe the V and the R reverse. That's not how you say it. And pretty much everybody knew that's how you said it. And they know it now because we explained it so many times. And it's very difficult.
Mike and Mike in the Morning, and obviously the genius that is Frank Caliendo.
Which one? Run the one with the horse?
Yep.
Hey, I wanted to talk about some horse racing today, actually.
Let's do it. That brings up one, and I know John Madden.
I want to talk about the horse involving Bob Bazard, can I?
Okay. Which one's the horse?
Well, it was the horse that won a Kentucky Derby.
Stevens, hold on, double away, will you? Lip front, get those feet up, will you? Get him up.
Hey,
isn't it?
Yeah, that's exactly what I wanted.
Yeah, Pops, you could take care of a whole room full of people with that gun. Maybe not kill them all, but then they wouldn't be good for anything afterwards.
I know you'd take care of it for me, Nicky. Say, how long you had this place?
Almost a year.
Yeah, that's picturesque enough, but there can't be much profit in it.
There isn't. But then there isn't much trouble in either. What are you thinking about?
A job. Your kind of a job. A job with a rifle.
What kind of money, Pops?
$5,000.
What would I have to kill?
A horse.
A horse?
A four-legged horse.
And for that, I get $5,000.
Well, for that, and...
I figured that'd be a gimmick.
Well, a gimmick isn't as tough as you may think. You shoot the horse, and if by any chance anything goes wrong, you don't squawk.
And all I got to do is bumble for a horse.
Well, it's a special kind of a horse, Nick.
Well?
For certain reasons, including your own protection in case anything happens, I'm not going to give you the whole story. Just your part of it. Next Saturday, the $100,000 handicap is being run. In the seventh race, that's the big race of the season, there's a certain horse running. He's one of the best three-year-olds to come along in the last 10 years. He's a big money winner, and he won't pay even money because half the people out there are going to be down on him.
Uh-huh.
All right. There's a parking lot less than 300 feet from the northwest corner of the track. From a car parked in the southeast corner of that lot, you get a perfect view of the horses as they come around the far corner and start into the stretch. A man sitting in a car parked in that spot using a high-powered rifle with a telescopic sight should be able to bring down any given horse with a single shot. And a man with your eye would hardly need a telescopic sight.
Well, that horse is worth $250,000, and you know the crowd would go completely nuts.
So what? Let them go nuts. You can do it, Nick. You can do it easy. And you shouldn't have too much trouble getting away in the confusion. Red Lightning will undoubtedly be leading in the stretch because that's the way he runs. So he goes down, a couple of other horses pile up on top of him. There'll be plenty of confusion, I can guarantee you that.
Yeah.
And there's one more thing. Suppose by accident you do get picked up. What have you done? You shot a horse. It isn't first-degree murder. In fact, it isn't even murder. In fact, I don't know what it is. But the chances are the best they could get you on would be... inciting a riot or shooting horses out of season or something like that.
The way you put it down, could you make it sound real simple, you know, Pops?
$5,000 for rubbing out a horse.
Okay, Pops, how do I get it?
$2,500 today, $2,500 the day after the race.
Okay, crazy. Now tell me something. What's your angle, John? They'll probably call the race off, huh? And they won't pay off any of the bets.
Yeah,
come on.
Maybe. But what my angle is my business. And, Nicky, $5,000 is a lot of dough, and that's what I'm paying it for, so nobody has to know my business.
All right, John, I got no troubles with you. I'm with you.
I'm looking for Joe Piano.
Who's looking for Joe?
Patsy sent me.
Patsy who?
Patsy Ginelli.
And where did you see Patsy?
Alcatraz. We roomed together. My name, Abbott.
Don't tell me who you are. What can I do for you?
I want a place to stay for about a week. I won't be in it very much. I don't want to clean it. And I don't want anybody else in it except myself.
I think I can accommodate you. So how's the boy?
Hey, he's fine. He's doing it on his ear. He's the best pitcher they got up there. And he
yeah,
told
I know.
Me to tell you not to worry about it.
Yeah, he's doing the book, you know. I worry plenty.
Well, he's a tough kid. Maybe he'll get a break.
Yeah, I know. Let's hope. Hey, well, I got another one. You don't have to worry about leaving anything in here. It'll be safe. I'm always over here. There'll be no maid service. Want to leave anything in there?
Just this and another bag next week.
Don't you worry. Nobody will disturb them.
All right, what'll it be?
Oh, no, no. No charge. You said Patsy sent you.
Sure, he sent me, but he's a friend of mine. I'd feel better if I paid. It's kind of a business arrangement. I can afford it.
Okay, then it'll be $10 a week. I'll send the money in the butts to the boy. Thank you very much. Have a nice time, huh?
All right, we're back in second hour of Chapdog Sports Talk. Going into the afternoon games.
Yes.
And the Our Picks Are Kicking and Screaming show. Yeah, I feel pretty good about most of these picks so far. That's dangerous.
How did you feel about them last week, though? Did you feel just as good?
I think I felt worse about it last week. I don't know why, but maybe I don't have the benefit of this week, last week's good picks behind me to kind of back me up a little bit. But the next game is a tough one. That's the there's in the minds of some people it's tough. Bengals at the Broncos.
Bengals and 7-6 Bengals coming to Denver to play surprisingly the 7-6 Broncos. Mm. 4:05 p.m. Eastern Time, 1:05 p.m. here off.
One team's coming off an impressive win, and the other team's coming off of a disappointing loss. A lot of people think they kind of gave that one away, but I think San Francisco's a good team. That's why they lost.
San Francisco's a good team. So, that was a great game, too.
So why don't we let – I mean, I'm definitely leaning towards the Bengals here just because I think they're going to right the ship. They have to. They need this game badly. The Broncos, I don't know. I don't understand that offense very well. Sometimes they show up and sometimes they don't. I think the Bengals will squeak it out.
Well, Teddy Bridgewater needs 46 passing yards for 3,000 on the season, which would be the first time in his career he's ever gotten 3,000 yards. Would that be great for Teddy Bridgewater? So he's pretty pumped up. He's had a career season here. But Cincinnati is 4-1 against the spread in its past five road games. So the Bengals are good at covering on the road, but this is mile high. Denver, 3-point home favorite, so it's just a no discount, straight up.
I'm going with the Bengals.
Licks? Oh, Licks?
Blix. I don't hear Blix.
Oh, Blix, mute. Oh, mute
there it
Blix.
Goes.
There he is.
I double tapped on the mute button and remuted my mic. Sorry about that. But this is a tough game to pick. I mean, I see good things coming from the Denver defense since they got rid of Von Miller, and they keep doing it week in and week out and somehow keeping games close. And the Bengals have the same problem as everybody else in the AFC North. They just cannot seem to string together multiple games consecutively with good offensive output. I want to take the Bengals in this game, but I do not trust them. So I'm going to go with the Broncos in the up. It's not an upset, but I think it's an upset.
Okay, mark you down for the Broncos. Abe.
Wow, this is a really tough game, as everybody's been saying. I do like I really like the offense of the Cincinnati Bengals in this game. Again, this is a tough game to pick, and if I'm ever going to catch up to Big Man Blix, I'm going to have I'm going to have to go against them on some of these games, and then this might be one of those games where
this is a prime
so close.
Opportunity.
This is an opportunity for me to get some points on Blix, and so let's look at Jeff. Let's look at Burroughs.
Hey, this is a golden opportunity to short Blix.
I mean, just short. Third.
There it is again. Damn short joke.
You know,
I can't use the word short.
You're shorting Blix, though.
I have a feeling his snake is about three times his body size. You know what I'm saying? which is okay. Blix,
keep guessing.
He's about three times bigger than mine, I'm sure. So let's.
That's the joke.
Let's. The Bengals have a stronger offense here than the Broncos. And it's just almost a money line pick here, and it's 50-50 how we're going to go. Let's go with the Bengals. Put me down.
Okay.
The Bengals.
And Chabadog was already taking the Bengals already.
What about you?
The Bengals keep screwing me, and both these teams keep screwing me. They both start with the letter B, Bengals and Broncos. Yeah. I've never lived in Cincinnati, but I have lived in Denver, so I'm taking the Broncos. It was a good experience. Nice city.
Yeah. All right, so we're split. 2-2.
Next up, the Falcons at the 49ers. The Atlanta Posers come to town. Mm. They masquerade as a football team. They are a 9-point road dog coming into San Francisco. 4:05 p.m. Eastern Time, 1:05.
Isn't that a lot of lumber?
Yeah.
It's a lot of lumber.
Yeah, but it's the Falcons and 49ers.
To lay on the Falcons.
I love saying this guy's name, Deebo Samuel.
Is he playing?
He's playing.
Oh. Yeah, I think the 49ers are going to celebrate not having to play a real tough team this week. So they needed a break. They were on a kind of a tough road swing. Mm-hmm. I think they'll be ready to win that game by 10. It's not an easy. It's definitely painful having it because their offense isn't that great.
Who's
the 49ers offense? Some weeks it's better than others.
Garoppolo.
Yeah, if he gets, I think it's the running game has to be on. I don't see why I think they're going to be able to actually. They should be able to overpower the Falcons. Mm-hmm. Yeah,
Falcons are giving up.
That's all 49ers.
6-7 Falcons against the 7-6.
I'm not getting sucked into that.
Yeah.
Okay.
Blix, are you going to get sucked into that?
No. My sister thinks she's going to have a conundrum watching this game because she's a big fan of Deebo Samuel and what the 49ers are doing to utilize him in the running and passing game has been immaculate. Get him the ball whenever you can get him the ball, however, and that's the way that offense is running. And the Falcons offense is just pitter-pattering, and that's her favorite team. So either way she looks at it, she's going to get a win in this game. But to me, this could almost be a shutout just because of how bad the Falcons offense is. And the 49ers will cover that spread. Give me the Niners. Uh-huh.
Now, this is one of those divisional games. Does anyone remember the outcome of when these two teams played? And they played already, right?
This is not a divisional game anymore. You just went back 20 years.
Oh, that's right. Okay. So you're taking the Falcons, then. No, sorry, you're taking the Niners.
I'm taking the Niners.
Taking the Niners, okay. And Chav Dog, it sounded like you were taking the 49ers.
I said that, yes.
Yeah. So that leaves Abe.
Where's that song go? I left my heart in San Francisco.
Mm-hmm.
I think I'm going to leave my heart in San Francisco today.
You don't want to go against the tide to be different?
So you know, I don't think so. I'm going here for the 49ers. Just made a
It's not too late.
I don't know. You know, the only thing I don't like is that the running back's out. That's about it.
Yeah, they'll find somebody else to run for them. They'll be okay. Yeah. Just
give it to somebody else, I guess.
Okay. Next game's a good one.
Yeah, the Packers at the Ravens, baby. Here we are.
Ravens
10-3 Packers against the 8-5 Ravens. 4:25 p.m. Eastern Time, 1:25 here at the dock.
Now the Ravens are rested, everybody. Let's remember that.
And Green Bay is a 7-point favorite right now on the road.
That's a lot of points,
Yeah, there's the lumber.
Is that? But that's reflecting no Lamar Jackson, right?
What about Lamar Jackson?
Is he playing?
We don't know. He's still listed as questionable, but I think that he's going to attempt to play.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it kind of does show that they've lost some respect for that offense and his capabilities because he's just been down for a bunch of weeks ever since that Miami game.
Mm-hmm.
And
yet they've still been winning games, but it's not. Yeah, the offense. Nobody fears Lamar Jackson anymore.
I don't know.
But that doesn't. They still
the Ravens at home getting that many points. That's scary.
I know. And the Packers, really? I mean, they're that good. They're just crushing people and throwing. I mean, they don't play the Bears every week. Hey, Abe, it would be nice if you could play the Bears every week.
I'm going with the Ravens. That's too many points. I just don't think anybody just walks in there and comes out with 10
points. Taking the Bears?
I'm going to take the Ravens.
Take the Ravens?
The Bears.
Ravens.
It's a big difference.
Yeah. Abe?
Let's see. Who's going to be playing? Will Aaron Rodgers be playing?
Oh, yeah. In fact,
if he's not playing,
he needs 4 touchdown passes to surpass Brett Favre. First place on the Packers' all-time list.
Nobody could ever surpass Brett Favre.
Well, guess what?
Don't tell John Madden that.
He's going to be pretty fired up. Yeah. We already played that, but yeah, that was Madden just went nuts.
Let's see. The other guy.
He's Favre-tastic.
Well, the other one is Aaron Jones. Is he running? Because it said limited participation in practice.
Oh, that doesn't mean you're.
Not much, right?
I think that means he's playing.
Yeah. I mean, just because Aaron Rodgers had something better else to do during
the
practice.
The Ravens actually performed pretty well last week against the Browns, didn't they? At the end, they came back. Did you see that game, Blix?
Of course I saw that game, and I watched the Browns go to a pre-bent defense in the second half. And
so what was going on? The Ravens, was it just the Browns softened up and the Ravens naturally took advantage of it?
About midway through the third quarter, everything kind of softened up. And then all of a sudden at the end, the Browns were like, oh, crap, we got to win this game, right? And they ended up winning. But there's nothing that the Ravens have right now that is exciting. I mean, you got a quarterback with a bum wheel now with his ankle injury, and he made the biggest mistake of his career by stating publicly that the NFL hadn't figured him out yet, and this is going to be another example of the NFL has figured out lame arm Jackson and the Packers easily cover that spread.
And, who's coaching the Ravens? Remember that guy's name?
Yeah, John Harbaugh.
That's right.
Yeah.
So everything you said, Blix, that's exactly what Harbaugh wants everyone to think. That Packers.
Well, watch the game. We'll see. I'm still taking the Packers because I don't believe in that Ravens offense at all.
Yeah. That's he's lured you in. He's luring you into the trap. That's the trap here. This guy's a smart coach.
Okay. I'm thinking I'm going to go down with the ship here.
Well, you're going with the Ravens. I'm taking the Ravens.
I don't buy that. I don't see that happen very often that they get blown out at home. It can happen, but
yeah. But 7 points, yeah. And I think this is a trap. Okay. But Packers are your team, Abe.
Packers are my team, and one of the things that I look at here is they have, as far as the numbers are concerned, the Baltimore is a little bit stronger than the Packers, but their defense is not as good. But they lost the Cleveland Browns, lost the Steelers. Packers have won against the Bears, won against the Rams, tough teams. You know, we're talking about one touchdown and one extra point to beat the Ravens. I like that. That's okay. I think we can do it. Get me a little bit higher up on that pick chart.
Okay.
So put me down for the Green Bay Acme Packers.
Okay, well, you and Blix, sir.
Remember, Justin Tucker is still healthy, and he can still kick. This pick is
65 yards, right? Was it something like 65?
65 or 66.
Jeez.
Was the one that
we got another guest, fellas.
Oh, look.
Well, no, come here, Marco. Don't roll over.
I like your guests. I like all your guests, Blix.
Of course, the dog ran away the moment.
First, we liked.
No, he rolled
cat
over on his back and said, "Rub my belly."
I missed it. Okay.
Oh.
Come here.
Oh, there he is.
Fire the camera, man. I can see something there.
Yeah.
Oh, there's a good boy. Okay.
You're spoiled.
Next.
The Saints. The Saints. Oh, it's on the next page here. All right, the Buccaneers, and this is really surprising. The 6-7 Saints.
A lot of work this week.
All right. There's no bye. All teams bye weeks are over.
This is definitely a pivotal week.
Got the full schedule. 6-7 Saints at the 10-3 Buccaneers. This is on Sunday night at 8:20. Tampa Bay is an 11.5 point home favorite. Imagine that, 11.5 points.
Tampa Bay's been great at covering. You know?
Oh, yeah. No, they have. But it's funny about the Saints. This is what's really weird. Brady has only won once.
I know.
Four times.
He's got a problem with the Saints.
He does.
I think their defense
scares the
crap out of him for some reason.
Yeah.
Like somebody really got in his face and intimidated him.
Yeah, something weird goes on when they play. So New Orleans has covered the past six regular season meetings, including winning outright as a home underdog in Week 8. So they've already beaten the Buccaneers once in Week 8, and they won, and so they want the Saints, Tampa Bay.
What happened last week to the Saints?
Oh, I don't know.
They lost.
Probably got lost big time.
They beat. Didn't they lose?
I didn't take them.
Oh no, they beat the Jets. They're on
Saints?
The. Yeah, they're on the ups.
But then they lost to Dallas. They lost to the Bills.
Maybe they lost to the Eagles last week.
They lost to the Titans.
Lost to the Cowboys.
I think it's too much. I'm going to go with the Saints.
The Bills blew them out 31-6. The Bills.
There's a little life. There's a little life left in those Saints.
You think the Saints can?
Yeah. Go with it.
11.5. Eh. Okay. Blix, what do you think?
That's a tough hill to climb. 11.5 points is a big spread, but there was an old saying when Brady was in New England, you cannot beat him twice in the same season. Uh-huh. And I got to go with that moniker, and I think they somehow, some way, find a way to cover that spread. Brady gets the job done, beats the Saints by 14.
Wow. Wow. So you're
you'll never learn. You guys just never learn. He's
gonna lift that pile of lumber.
Tom Brady is a mere mortal.
11.5.
Abe, it's
11.5.
11.5 is a lot of points for the Bucks, but I also think that the Bucks are pretty damn good too. So let's put me down for the Tampa Bay Bucks.
Yeah.
You know, Tom Brady's got what, 4,100, over 4,100 yards.
This is a chance for you to gain on Blix.
4,100. No, I think we're going the same. We're picking the same, right?
Yeah. Eric, did you pick?
I haven't yet. Yeah. But, so Chab Dog's on Chab Dog Island right now.
I have to go to the island occasionally. There's only one. That's the only way to.
Just go to Abe's Island. He said there's rum.
Yeah, this is a game where I was really leaning hard into the Saints here, and the betting numbers show that that's where the trend is right now. However, this is prime time. Remember, this is Sunday, prime time. Tom Brady, prime time.
Mm.
Yeah, he's going to show up. Give me the Bucks, and yeah, they'll cover. They'll win by 14.
You know, the money line for the Saints is plus 425.
Yeah, there you go.
Wow.
No, they're not going to win the game. That's pretty good.
But 11.5. Saints, yeah. I think the Bucks are just going to be so much better.
Minus 600 for the Bucks.
Yeah,
that's a lot.
It's like it's bank interest. Nothing.
You got it. Yeah. All right. Might as well just yeah.
Okay, then on Monday night. So we have the original Monday night football game, and we have three more come on afterwards. But we have the original Monday night schedule game: the Vikings at the Bears. The Vikings 6-7 against the Bears 4-9. 8:15 Eastern time, 5:15 here at the dock. Minnesota 6-point home favorite. All right. Well, this used to be a really good game, and these used to be really good teams. But the Vikings have only won 5.
Minnesota's not the home favorite. They're the road favorite.
The last 21 times these teams played, the Vikings have only won 5 times. Yeah, and they're playing in Chicago. And Kirk Cousins is 1-9 in 10 games on Monday Night Football. So even though the Bears suck, and they like suck to high suckitude, and it looks really good because the Vikings, you know, don't. This isn't a strength for them either. It would be very tempting to take the Bears, but the Bears, they suck.
But this game is always freaking 20-18 or something stupid. It's always low scoring. Nobody. Did the Vikings ever take control, particularly in Chicago, this game? I don't think they do.
No, yeah, these Vikings usually lose. The Bears win outright, even when they're having bad years. But Chicago was 0-4 against the spread.
Is there something really wrong with the Bears? Yes. You can tell me.
Yes, there is something
like
really.
Half the team's got COVID or something.
No, the team sucks. That's what's wrong with the Chicago Bears. But I can tell you that in the last 5 games that they've played, they've only won against the Detroit Lions, and that was 16-14.
I know. That was a struggle.
Right. That was a struggle to beat the Lions. That's where we're at, Bears. 16-14.
And they got blown
that's what
out
you
the
that's
last game.
When you say when they go to dinner and they talk to mama, they go, "Yeah, mama, we beat the Detroit Lions 16-14. Six. That's the only thing they can talk about in their in their victories here.
This is a really tough game.
It is tough.
Yeah, you're right.
No, it's not. It's the Vikings. That's it. That's what's hard about.
They don't beat
about.
Anybody by a lot.
That's 6 points?
Bend
6
over here. It comes again.
6? They beat the Steelers by eight.
I'm forgetting what they did to the Steelers and how.
Did you forget?
Thinking about the end of the game.
Now let's also remember the Vikings did lose to the Lions. That was pretty sad. They had a fluke there. They had a fluke there.
All right, go with the Vikings. Just move on.
Wow, really? You're gonna see
just
that
give in to the temptation.
That's just me, you know. I don't know.
All right, so
that's rich.
Don't listen to me. I only picked 11 games last week.
Did you pick anybody or not?
I did. I picked the Vikings. This is like this is one of those I picked in my sleep.
Okay. you conceded to the Vikings, Chab Dog and Blix.
Don't tell me you're going with the Bears. Are you going with the Bears?
I'm picking the Vikings.
Are you going with the Bears?
I get killed when I take the Bears, but
yeah, go for it. Go for it.
Yeah, go take. Just take a little puff of the Bears. No one will see.
In the words of
6 points.
Oh no! That's so many points against
the Bears. But it's the Bears. It's the Detroit Lions of Illinois. I mean, come on now.
No! Pick them.
Really? I'm not picking the Bears. I can't do it. I cannot do it. Looking at everything.
Nobody pick the damn Bears.
I'm taking the Vikings.
Y'all pick the Bears. I'm good.
No, I'm taking the Vikings in this one.
I was the lone person who took the Bears against the Packers last week, and I was the lone person who lost that game.
I
remember Blix. Yeah, we texted back and forth. In the first half, the Bears were prima donnas. They were doing everything right.
45-30. Right. That was 15 points.
Exactly.
That was a 15-point smack.
Last 30 minutes of that game were completely different. Bears just couldn't finish, so I'm not taking
We've beaten this bear to death.
Now that bear's going to beat the Vikings.
You're fucking freaking out. Okay.
That's what's going
to
happen.
All right, well, okay, now we finished the regular games. Now it's time to the makeup games. We have three makeup games.
The COVID makeup games.
Tuesday games, too?
Yeah, but we'll start with your next game on
Tuesday
Monday.
Football.
So at 5 o'clock Eastern, 2 p.m. Chab Dog time. So perfect in the middle of our workday afternoon on Monday. We have the Raiders at the Browns. Browns. Okay, it's been vacillating all over the place.
This will be a real offensive showcase, let me tell you.
Courtesy of DraftKings Sportsbook.
Cleveland has no quarterback, and the Raiders are
And yet the Browns are favored by 1 point.
They're a messed up house.
Yeah, Baker Mayfield and Case Keenum are likely out. Nick Mullins. There we go. That's
the great Nick Mullins.
The great Nick Mullins, Blix.
I think he played for the Niners.
It's a horrible situation right now in Cleveland. I mean, everything on this injury report is bad news for Browns fans like me. Clowney out. Hooper out. Landry out. Keenum out.
It's like they shot their wad last week against the Ravens.
Pretty much.
They're just down for the count.
Cornerback,
right,
A.J. Green, out. Safety, Grant Delpit, out. Kareem Hunt, out. Baker Mayfield, out. This is ridiculous.
I'm going with the Raiders. I'm doing it.
This is a setup. This is a massive setup for a Raiders win. If the Raiders don't win this game, their fans should disown them.
Yeah, they don't have a pulse if they can't win.
Like I said earlier, the Browns are basically a high school team.
But the Browns
are basically a high school team at home.
Because nobody trusts the Raiders.
There's nobody.
That's just the bottom line.
So the Raiders have had to stay an extra night in a hotel room. And because of that, the Browns are still favored by one? I don't get it.
I don't get that either.
It says Baker Mayfield had a full participation in practice, and
he's not playing. Oh.
Sounds like he's playing.
Hope he's back.
Well, you know, it doesn't matter. There's nothing else there, and this could change between now.
It could change between now and Monday,
but with all the COVID cases, we don't even know if Stefanski's going to be able to coach.
If he's playing, they're going to find a way to win, I think.
You've got to fake a test for him or just put through the results.
So just change my vote.
To Browns. Oh,
you're going back to Browns?
Yeah.
Wow, I'm really confused.
I don't like doing that, but this is a special situation.
Blix, are you going to take the Browns or are you going to bet against your team?
Blix is creating a smoke screen.
Yeah.
He's trying to create interest in the Raiders, even though he's not going to take the Raiders.
Yes, I am taking the Raiders. That is the funny thing. I'm going to take the Raiders because everything that I just told you on that injury report, I mean, and Jarvis Landry, even though it's not COVID-related, is still out of this game. There's nobody else to throw the ball to. So it's going to be on nothing but Nick Chubb. And our secondary has not been able to stop a number one receiver, and Hunter Renfrow has been going off for the Raiders the past couple of weeks. This game really screams Raiders.
Yeah, it screams.
Baker will play, and it'll be okay. That's what I'm saying.
Well, I hope so, but I'm still taking the Raiders.
I mean, and to your favor, Cleveland's 0-4 against the spread in its past four games, but Vegas is 1-5 over its past six games.
And this is there's no spread here. It's just, do they win or not?
Browns or
and I think the Browns have lost the last three or four games against the Raiders.
We're using Browns minus one.
The Browns realize they're back in the race, so they have to win this game, and they will.
Yeah, 7-6. It's that simple.
I don't think the Raiders really believe that they're a playoff
team. They're swirling the toilet right now. They're swirling the toilet, the Raiders are.
No, they said on the news, the Browns have, they have the inside track to the division. ESPN stated it, and the very next day, COVID said, go fuck yourself, Cleveland.
Yeah. Yeah. All right, Abe?
You know what I really love about this game is the fact that it's not a huge spread. What are you talking about? 1 point money line pick? Yeah. This is a money line pick. Are you going to go with the Raiders? You're going to go with the Browns? I know that the Browns are hurting. COVID's got that whole team all jacked up. You know, the Raiders just got to win by one. No, they just got to win, period. They just got to win. And that looks pretty good to me. I like those odds. So put me down for the Las Vegas Raiders.
Yeah. I think you're swaying me here. I really am undecided here, but I think the Raiders are. Oh, geez, I always get burned when I take the Raiders.
Yeah, go ahead and do it. Just go ahead and do it.
I mean, both these teams suck.
Leave Chab Dog on his island.
It's coin flip.
He's like that kid in high school. It's like, it's okay. Just take one hit. You don't know what's going to say nothing.
It's worth it. It feels so good. You'll feel so dirty afterwards.
You'll feel
that's
like.
That's the problem with you pick the Raiders. You feel dirty immediately.
Yeah, exactly. I'll take the Browns.
He picked the Browns. Yeah, you won't do it, damn Jedi. You Jedi.
He couldn't do that to me. That wouldn't be right.
He's a Jedi.
We got two more of these babies.
Yeah, we're down two more. Now we move to Tuesday.
Oh yeah, it's good. Tuesday night football, guys.
So at 7 p.m. on Tuesday, Eastern, which should be 4 p.m. Pacific here, so sure, we can leave work early. The Seahawks are visiting the Rams here. So, yeah, so all those people buy tickets at SoFi for Sunday now have to show up on Tuesday at 4 p.m. and see the Seahawks arrive in town. The Rams are a 5.5-point favorite. And let's see, who do we have out? So out in this game, Odell Beckham Jr., and Jalen Ramsey are on the COVID death list. And let's see if the Seahawks can. Well, they got a two-game winning streak coming in here.
Yes, Seahawks are hot.
They're hot.
The Rams think they're hot.
So is Matthew.
And the Rams are favored by what?
Rams are favored by 5.5.
Oh, that spread is not quite as swollen as I thought it would be. Mm-hmm. And Seattle's definitely looking like they believe there's a reason for them here in this season somehow that they can claw their way back to a playoff situation. So
yeah, Seattle actually thinks they can. I'm a Seattle fan. The Divers off the dock here.
This really looks Seahawks to fan. Me like
he's deluded and thinks that win last week.
The Seahawks are healthy. Is that right?
Well, yeah, they don't have COVID if that's what you mean.
I don't know. I'm just trying to get some bruises and Abe, if there's any major problems simmering under.
Well, I do see that Alex Collins, their running back, is out. I also see that Tyler Lockett, their wide receiver, is out. That's not good. These are your two. This is your top running back, And then you got your top wide receiver.
Okay, Rams. Rams next.
Then you have Adrian Peterson, which is another running back who's on questionable. You know, that could be a factor here on the Rams side.
He's like a million years old.
Well, he's there, yeah, but he's questionable. That's who they're going to be throwing it to.
Wow. Okay. Yeah.
Because Alex Collins is not going to be there. Well, he's out as of December 17. So that's what we got. Now, the only thing on the Rams, you do have Daryl Henderson Jr. He's one of their star running backs there for the Los Angeles Rams, and he's not going to be there, too. He's out. So that kind of cancels them out there on the running game.
Matthew Stafford will be playing, and he has 33 touchdown passes this season. He's tied with Vinny Testaverde and Brett Favre for the third most by a player in his first season with a new team. There's a useless fact for you.
That's a good useless fact.
He's got some pride here to be throwing for another touchdown, breaking that record.
Definitely wants to break that record. Yeah. And he will he's got 33 touchdowns, so a lot of touchdowns. There's a lot of gas coming from Stafford. Also going to be at SoFi Stadium, going to be at home here. Here in L.A.
Testaverde's pretty cool.
So put me down for the Rams.
Okay, Blix?
Yeah, I'm going to agree with Abe and take the Rams on this one. Seattle's just right now. I mean, my goodness. I don't know whether to say they've overstayed their welcome, basically, as being a top team in the NFC West, but they pretty much have, and now the Rams and the Cardinals have taken over that division, and the Rams prove it once again that Seattle is not the Seattle of yesteryear, and it's time to make a change in Washington State.
They're the Seattle this year.
Yeah.
They're going to play like the Kraken.
Mediocre at best.
Exactly. They're going to play like the Kraken.
They're going to play like the Kraken against the LA team.
All right, unanimity again there. Last game.
It's going to be
last
an insult. Game.
Oh, all right, Washington at the Eagles.
Washington, 6-7 Washington, and losing to Dallas. All the wind is out of their sails now. What a shame. It was so great to believe, though. But 6-7 Washington at the Eagles, which, guess what? They're 6-7 also. Both these teams. Both these teams suck. Somebody's going to suck even worse when this game is finished after Tuesday night at 7 p.m. Eastern, 4 p.m. Here on the dock, and Philly is a 7.5-point home favorite.
Oh, God, that's a lot, man. That's a lot.
Washington has like a dozen players on the COVID death list.
Oh.
So, including their quarterbacks and stuff.
You mean, there's no Tyler Meinicke?
No, he's out. Maybe he'll be back by then. But
who's playing then?
Oh. Well, they got this other guy named White, but I don't know. He lost the game for a while. Well, he almost won it, too.
I think Meinicke should show up in a muffler, and then he'd be okay.
Yeah, he makes great mufflers. He certainly does that.
All right.
Philly is 5-12 against the spread as a home favorite since 2018.
Is Jalen Hurt okay? Is Jalen Hurts hurt, or is he playing?
Nobody knows. I just pulled it up on ESPN and
nobody
knows. Jalen Hurts or Garner Minshew. At least Washington has narrowed Philly's starting quarterbacks to two.
They have Minshew.
They have Minshew.
This is another game that Minshew could really sink his teeth into.
Minshew.
Yeah, I think he could. I think he's going to score a bunch of points.
I think he has a funny name.
The foreskins are history.
They got so excited when they
I'm jumping off of the bandwagon this week.
Oh well.
Into the Minshew corner.
You like Minshew? So I'm put you down for Minshew.
To the Minshew mouthpiece.
Well, it says here that Washington believes Kyle Allen.
Allen, yeah.
Washington's primary QB, good chance of playing on Tuesday.
He was actually ahead of Heinicke back at the beginning of the year.
Yeah, good. That's good. That's good.
Behind, Ryan Fitzpatrick?
Maybe Kyle Allen will be as good as Kyle Larson or even Kyle Busch.
Aren't there like 10 Kyles that do NASCAR?
Yeah, that's a lot of Kyles, that's for sure. I think if your name is Kyle, you have a good chance of being a NASCAR driver.
Okay, so what do you think, Abe?
You know, this one's tough, but not too tough. only because, you know, Washington's hurting. This is an Eagles home game.
Yeah.
I like the, you know.
I would peg you for the Eagles on this one.
Oh, I'm going to get pegged. Nice. Let's do it live, though. If I'm going to get pegged, I want to do it live.
Wow.
I'm going to get pegged by the Chab Dog live.
With no Vaseline.
You just got crucified. You didn't just get pegged. Pre-Christmas.
Make sure
crucifying.
We have safe words in place if we're going to do it.
Not Easter, though.
Wow.
The safe word is cracking.
Yeah, it's this one's tough because the number. But
yeah, what's the safe word for this one?
The safe word is Eagles. That's the safe word. Okay. That's the safe word for this game.
Eagles. All right, Blix, I know you want to pick the Redskins, so go ahead.
Okay.
Right.
You just made my pick for me. Abe actually has a chance to catch up if the Eagles can actually play offense.
All right.
This is a special gift from Blix, his knowledge about this game.
The knowledge about this game is I'm not watching that game.
They're
both horrible teams. I still don't understand how either one of them is 6-7. But in the past month, the Foreskins have showed more promise than the Eagles. So I'm taking the Foreskins.
I think you're missing the magic of Minshew.
Yeah,
I
think Philly's going to miss it too on Tuesday night.
Garner.
Oh, okay. Minshew. No magic.
Yeah.
What about you?
I have two words for you. Yeah, all exactly. Right. Those are the two
last
words.
Last pick of the day. Are you
Garner,
taking,
Minshew.
Who are you going with?
Put me down for Washington. This is where the half point kills you. Mm-hmm. Yeah, the Eagles will probably win. And they'll probably be up by an impressive amount, well past 7.5 points deep
into the
game.
They'll win by 7.
And they'll win
I'm guessing it'll be 8.
I think it'll be more like 6.
The Redskins will kick that field goal to make it 8.
Somebody will miss a two-point conversion.
Have it set up for the last drive, and they won't be able to stop the Eagles.
It'll be watch it.
Yes, yeah, the Eagles might win the game, but they're not covering. Sorry.
Yeah. Okay. Well, then we got through somehow. We did it. We got through everything.
Yeah, we got through everything.
I did want to talk about horse racing briefly.
Horse racing?
Yeah.
What about F1?
Oh, well.
We'll talk about horse racing. We'll
okay, you both. Can. You want to do car or F1 first, and we'll finish up with horse racing.
Yeah,
Max Verstappen, once again, your racing segment team, once again, picks the world champion F1 driver, Max Verstappen, the same guy who picks Kyle Larson to win it all for NASCAR. In my first season here at Chab Dog Sports, if there's anything I take pride in is at least being able to pick some good racing drivers. There was, of course, like anything in F1, great controversy. There was a great controversy at the end, which is always like a hook for next season, in that essentially Hamilton was leading the entire race. He was up by like 11-something seconds. The only thing Hamilton didn't do really was change his tires because he's like, I don't need to change my tires. I'm just going to win this race. And, of course, as we come to the end and the closing chapter of the race, there's a wreck. The safety car comes out. Max Verstappen comes in, and he essentially just takes over and beats Hamilton in the last lap of the race because he got himself a new set of tires. But the controversy is that all the lap cars between Max Verstappen and Hamilton, which were about 5 cars in front of him because it was 11-second lead, these were lapped cars. The race official said, let them pass. Let them pass ahead of the safety car to go all the way to the back, causing no gap, a zero gap between Hamilton and Max Verstappen. And that basically becomes a shootout, very much a shootout at the last race. And of course, Max Verstappen, he has a new fresh set of soft tires. Hamilton is still on some old tires. Max Verstappen comes, beats Hamilton, and that was it. He's crowned victory. You know, did Mercedes appeal it? They did. They were pissed, but then they dropped it. They dropped it, and that's it. They just let it go. And so whatever asterisk they want to put on Max Verstappen, well, that asterisk is gone because Mercedes, Hamilton, they're just letting it go. And you know what? There's some fault. You know what? It's a risk. You take a risk. You don't change your tires. Okay, you're taking a risk. That's how racing goes. It's not, you know, you have to know, yes, you got 11 seconds, but you know the last five laps, things are going to get crazy. Think drivers are going to get aggressive. Wrecks can happen, and that means the safety car is going to come out. So you got to think tires. And, you know, that's the risk. Mercedes said, let's not change the tires. Max Verstappen team said, come in and pit. Change the tires. Hamilton could have changed the tires. He didn't want to change the tires. Max Verstappen, they didn't have to change the tires. But he said, come on, take a risk. You take a risk when you go into the pit road. And you know what? That's just at the end of the day, they just took, you know, the risk favored Red Bull.
Okay, you know, that's part of racing, I think.
That's what it is.
Yeah, what's that scene in Days of Thunder? That scene in Days of Thunder when he's trying to teach Tom Cruise how to actually drive a stock car is tires is what wins races. And there's another example of it. The guy that took the tires ends up winning the race.
That's it.
I ain't much of a living really boy.
You can always count on Max Verstappen to know when to stop.
Well, you know, that just
how could you expect anything less?
Yeah, he's just he's been on fire all season. So, you know, it wasn't just this one race, one lap.
Sorry, Hamilton.
It was a whole season worth of lots of wins for Max Verstappen that led to this point. So it wasn't just one lap. Yeah. It wasn't just one race. It was all the races leading up to that moment.
I like, though, it was mano a mano at the end.
Oh, it was mano to mano, but Hamilton was, you know, he didn't have the fresh set of tires because he was banking on his 11-second lead, and I'm just going to finish this race like that.
Bend over here. It comes again.
That's right,
exactly.
Congratulations.
You got bohekaed.
So what do we got in horse racing? What's scandal today?
The guy on the radio was talking about how Baffert, the guy that won the Kentucky Derby and his horse got tested positive. That's not a coincidence. It's happened to him a lot, and it's becoming a problem.
Like, and his horse died.
They haven't really taken any action against him, but he had a whole bunch of horses die on him.
That one died.
Yeah. So it's there's an animal rights aspect to this. The rules are in there to protect the animals and the integrity of the sport.
Well, you know, also one of their – a trainer just got sent to jail for 5 years and had to pay $23 million in fines because he was juicing the horses.
I don't know all the rules.
You get almond milk and you could juice horses?
I don't know what he's juicing it with, but he's been
– There's some rule about when you can inject their joints with painkillers or whatever. Mm-hmm. And if you play around with those rules, it can
– they call it doping. You're allowed to
– it can benefit you.
How much you're allowed to dope in horses? Like, it's like, what?
Yeah.
I didn't think you allowed
it. It's not like you can't put anything into the horse. It's just the timing is important. You can't do it a certain number of days before – whatever before
burn off before the test.
Yeah. So if you don't get that right,
it's just bad for the sport. It's just it's terrible for the people that are betting against, you know, certain horses, for those who are betting on the juiced horses, on the doped horses, totally it's great. But for those who are not, you know, it's just such an unfair advantage to them. And you know, those folks do not get their money back in all these settlements.
The suggestion is that there's not a real strong governing body.
Just needs to like there needs to be a way to test these horses. Like you really have to have a good system here.
Each other apparently.
You just gotta test them horses.
Yeah. All I can say is be careful. You don't want to wake up in bed with a horse's head not your feet.
Oh, now that would be
like that producer.
There, remember it's tough.
Waltz.
Godfather. So we're at the end of the show.
All right. So we've come to the bitter end here. Why don't you play Bust a Move?
Oh, yeah.
You go out with Bust a Move.
That whole song running the whole time. They're probably going to shut us down.
Is that going to get us blocked or something?
We have violated policies.
All right. Well,
our stream is currently interrupted.
We're breaking
have
rules.
A great week.
We're breaking rules now. How about that?
Yeah. Well, we're rebels over here. We're rebels at Chab Dog Sports.
Hey.
We don't do that. We're not ESPN. We're Chab Dog Sports.
Before we say our goodbyes,
you come here to
news.
We're the kids in the bathroom during school. That's
smoking
who we're
in
at.
The boys
we're,
room.
We're the kids smoking in the stalls while everybody else is in class.
I got two pieces of two pieces of news that have come across from ESPN. I'm sorry if I misenunciate this guy's name. Bailey Zappe sets new single season FBS touchdown record. Just broke Joe Burrow's 60 touchdown passing record. He threw his 61st touchdown pass against Appalachian State today. So, congratulations to him. Congratulations to him for setting that mark. And also,
And
also,
West Kentucky.
I'm going to find that picture.
And also, the Mets, the New York Mets actually have a manager now. And apparently, they listen to the Twitter feeds. Buck Showalter officially announced as the Mets manager.
Wow.
Okay.
Showalter.
Is he related to Buck Showalter?
That's what I said, Buck Showalter.
Oh, you said Buck Showalter. I see Bob.
Yeah, I know there has been a lot of cries for him on Twitter.
Well, that's a guy that's been recycled quite a few times.
But he's a winner.
Show me the Showalter.
Yeah.
Okay. We'll see what he's got.
Wow, that's going to be interesting season this year. I'm kind of excited for the Mets this season.
Okay.
It's going to be interesting.
Going to put a little bit of.
They also got some
a little bit of discipline into the Mets camp.
Mustafa,
okay, thank you, Mustafa. Thank you, Esteban.
Nice photography.
Yes,
we salute Mustafa.
Wonderful, wonderful work on the photography, and it's so comfortable in here. I don't know.
Warmer, yeah.
I can't wait to look at my more comfortable face.
I can't wait for us to be back outside again, but 60 degrees are warmer.
So I hope everybody's team busts a move today. This is definitely a pivotal week. So it's make it or break it week in the NFL, in my opinion, right here.
That's
this is where the rubber hits the road, and you better have the right tires on, damn it.
I'm the only one who's taking the Colts. I'm going to be watching that game. If you're watching that game,
on a limb.
That's all right. That's okay. That's
the cost of greatness, you know.
You know what? What is that, 2 points? Two points, guys.
Okay.
That's nothing.
I'll be watching, and I'll blow up your Twitter feed, Abe.
Good. Blow it up.
With every time the Patriots score, I'm going to blow your Twitter feed up.
That long snake around my Twitter feed. Shout out to the TP. Saturdays are for the boys. See Kraken.
All right, bust a move.
Don't suck tonight.
Oh, at the risk of failing YouTube, here we go. We're gonna rock it anyway. Have a great week, everybody.
All right.
Oh, and we'll be on, maybe next Friday, maybe next Sunday, but the show won't be on Christmas Day.
Next Sunday is the next show.
26. We'll talk to you then. Bye, buddy.
Bye.
Here's a jam for all the fellas. Try to do what those ladies tell us. Get shot down cause you're overzealous. Play hard to get females to jealous. Okay, smarty, go to a party. Girls are scantily clad and showing body. A chick walks by, you wish you could sex her, but you're standing on the wall like you was Poindexter. Next day's function, high class luncheon. Food is served and you're stone cold munching. Music comes on, people start to dance, but then you ate so much you nearly split your pants. A girl starts walking, guys start gawking. Sits down next to you and starts talking. Says she wanna dance cause she likes the groove, so come on, fatso, and just bust the move. Just bust the move. And you're wishing someone could cure your lonely condition. Looking for love in all the wrong places. No fine girls, just ugly faces. From frustration, first inclination is to become a monk and leave the situation. But every dark tunnel has a light of hope. So don't hang yourself with a celibate rope. New movie showing, so you're going. Could care less about the five you're blowing. Theater gets dark just to start the show. Then you spot a fine woman sitting in your row. She's dressed in yellow. She says, hello, come sit next to me, you fine fellow. You run over there without a second to lose. And what comes next? Hey, bust a move. Just bust a move. City. Ladies look pretty. Guys tell jokes so they can seem witty. Tell a funny joke just to get some play. Then you try to make a move and she says no way. Girls are faking, goodness saking. They want a man who brings home the bacon. Got no money and you got no car, then you got no woman. And there you are. Some girls are sadistic, materialistic. Looking for a man makes them opportunistic. They're lying on the beach perpetrating a tan so that a brother with money can be their man. So on the beach you're strolling, real high rolling. Everything you have is yours and not stolen. A girl runs up with something to prove, so don't just stand there and bust the move. Break it down for me, fellas. Has a brother Larry. In 5 days from now he's gonna marry. He's hoping you can make it there if you can, cause in the ceremony you'll be the best man. You say neato, check your libido, and roll to the church in your new tuxedo. The bride walks down just to start the wedding, and there's one more girl you won't be getting. So you start thinking, then you start clicking. A bridemaid looks and thinks that you're winking. She thinks you're kinda cute, so she winks back. And now you're feeling really firm, cause the girl is stacked. Reception's jumping, bass is pumping. Look at the girl and your heart starts thumping. Said she wanna dance to a different group. Now you don't want to do G, bust the move.
Let's do it.